everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to day 12 of Project Wood Elves. I apologize for not having gotten the video up in the last, I guess, 4 or 5 days. If you saw the previous video, I've been very, very sick, but that's okay. I'm working off about 75, maybe 80% capacity at this point, but I need to get started, and I need to get up for a while, so I'm going to paint today, and hopefully make some progress. I got to think about it. This is actually kind of good, I think, because, as I said, I wanted this to sort of simulate what would happen if I had a sort of normal job. And I think this is good, because a lot of the times, you know, you work a full 8, 9, 10 hours, you get home, you really just don't feel like doing anything. And so, you may miss a couple days. And so what I'm hoping is that I'll still be able to complete the project in time, even though I have missed a few days worth of working. And that's perfectly fine. I think that'll be an encouragement to some of you guys out there to work and continue to move forward on your own armies, even though you feel like sometimes, you know what, I just don't feel like doing anything today, or, you know, I'm too sick, or, you know, I'm too busy, you know, the kids, it's a birthday, or, you know, I got to spend time with the wife, or whatever it may be. So again, I think this is a good thing. We've missed a few days, but that's, again, it's perfectly all right. Excuse me. I don't really necessarily have any goals for the day. I will tell you my goal for the week, though. By next Monday evening anyway, I'm figuring on working through Monday, my hope is to have all of the Glade Guard finished, and then another unit fully assembled and ready to be primed on Tuesday, so that I can start painting them on Wednesday. All right. I don't know what that unit's going to be at this point. Right now, I'm thinking it's probably going to be the 2 units of 12 Dryads. And the reason I'm thinking that is because the work for the Glade Guard is going to be a lot of layering work, whereas for the Dryads, it's going to be mostly dry brushing, so it's going to go very quickly. And I think that'll be a nice sort of break away from my normal painting style. So, anyway, give me a few hours. I'll come back. I'll show you exactly what we got done today. I'm shooting for today. I know I've got to get the rest of the faces finished. And what I'm hoping to do is paint all of the boots of the miniatures. If I can get that far, I'll be happy. Hopefully, we'll be able to go even farther than that, but who knows? We'll see. Anyway, join in just a couple of seconds, and I'll show you exactly what we got finished. Welcome back. It's been about 3 hours, roughly, and I'm going to go ahead and quit for the evening. But I did get quite a bit done today. Ran into a little snag when I did the faces. I had forgotten to paint lips on the miniatures that don't actually have the green stuffed cowls on, or the green stuffed face masks, I guess I should say. So I had to go back and do that. That took about half an hour's worth of my time, trying to get the appropriate width and size of the lips down. But that's okay. We will pick up tomorrow and be renewed and have more energy, hopefully, anyway. But other than finishing up the faces, I got one set of boots completely done. So there's 16 miniatures that have their boots completely done. The set that you see in front of you, this is 16 guys who their boots have been blacked and they're ready to be started tomorrow. These should run a lot faster than the ones I did earlier today. Let me show you those. These I'm probably just going to do some edge highlights on because I'd like the boots to actually remain relatively black and not end up looking gray. These are the ones that actually have their boots finished. These guys, if you'll notice, let me sort of move them apart just a touch so they're not all over the place there. Okay. All right, these guys actually have brown boots, if you can see. Not the best highlighting job in the world, but again, this is very, very speedy painting, trying to get all this done in 49 days. But I think I picked up relatively where the sun would shine on each one of these miniatures. And I know what you're saying, some of you, Christopher, why do you have 2 different color boots on your miniatures? They're actually going to end up having 3 different color boots. it's called randomization. It's basically a way to make your units look diverse, yet at the same time still look like they're part of a nice cohesive unit. And so what I do every time I get in here and start working is I take all the miniatures and I divide them up into units, and then once I've got them in their units, what I do is I come in and I tip them over and I paint something on the bottom of their base. This guy's got a green base. That means he belongs in the green unit, as does this guy. This guy belongs in the red unit. All right. And so what I do is I just pile them all together and I pull out however many guys I need for a particular unit. All right. And whoever comes out, whether it be red or green, or there's probably a blue one somewhere on here. Yeah, there's a blue guy. All right. Whoever comes out, those are the guys that get the brown boots. All right. I pull another 16 out, and whatever color is on their bases, these guys all get the black boots. And that way you have differentiation within the unit, so it doesn't look like everybody shops at the same tailor. But at the same time, the unit still appears nice and cohesive because you're using the exact same colors within the unit, all right? And it looks really, really nice. Or within the entire scale of the army, all right? Because there will be black parts on these guys who have the brown boots, and there will be brown parts on these guys that have the black boots, okay? So it's all, you're using the same colors, you're just using them in different areas of the miniature, basically. All right? And yes, for those of you wondering, I will be doing that for the rest of the miniatures. So, you know, when we get up here to painting the capes, for instance, all right, some of these guys are going to have green capes. Some of them are going to have brown capes. You know, you may even see some with yellow capes. I don't know. It's just going to kind of depend on what I feel like doing when I get there. But I want to make the units not as monochromatic as most of the display units that you see nowadays. Everything's all one color. It just looks really boring. And this adds a little spice and flavor to the units. It's something that was done back in the early to mid-90s, and it's just been kind of forgotten about because people assume it takes a lot longer than it really does. But anyway, that's it for today, guys. So 16 guys have had their boots completely finished. Everybody's got a face now, and I think what I'm going to do is just keep the faces like they are. I think everybody seems to like them as they are, and I got to thinking about this. You know, if this were an army I was painting up for a full-scale display quality, I think I would go back and take the time to redo the faces. But because it's a painting challenge, and it's a speed challenge, I'm going to do the best that I can in the time allotted. So if I've got some time at the end of the 49 days and I want to come back and fix a few faces, you know, really if I do that, all I'm going to have to do is come in, paint a little bit extra face mask and a little bit of extra hood on the front, or on the fronts of each one of the miniatures, because that's really the only area that's going to get messed up. So what I'm going to do is just leave them like they are for now, finish up the rest of the miniatures, see what they look like, and then maybe come back and do some extra work on them a little bit later on. But anyway, that's it for now, guys. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comments section down below. And hopefully, Lord willing, I will see you guys tomorrow, or at least you'll see me tomorrow. And that's it for right now, guys. So God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.